chakras, my chakras, I smoke a lotus. Hold the crown in my bones, in my chakras, I smoke a lotus. I smoke a bounce, and my niggas pull around with the choppers. We got the choppers, hold the crown in my bones, in my chakras, I smoke a... So far, just got here. I already found some oyster mushrooms. These are fall oysters. This one got bit by an animal. I'll leave that one there. Some more over here. Baby ones popping up over here. More baby ones popping up over here. Small little baby one. Oyster mushrooms have no poisonous lookalikes. These are like really common, really easy to find if you're a beginner when it comes to foraging mushrooms in the woods. But you know these are oyster mushrooms because they have gills or forked gills. It almost looks like a fork. And they don't have any stems. And another thing about oyster mushrooms is that they don't have stems. They grow in clusters and you don't see a stem. These are brown during the fall, but during the springtime, they're all white. So these are fall oysters. I'm gonna harvest a couple. I'm gonna leave oyster mushrooms. I'm gonna leave this one that got bitten. You wanna leave a couple of them, because eventually when they get to their prime stage and they get old, they'll start sporulating and spores will drop out from the underside, and it'll get all the mist will get on the trees and more of them will grow. So yeah, don't be selfish and take all of them. You always want to leave some for nature so that they can reproduce and leave the babies. These will continue to grow. In a couple days they'll be big, 3 days, 4 days, and I'll be back, see what else we can find. And not even a minute down the lane, some more oyster mushrooms. Cool. This one got bit too. Ooh, there's a nice little fresh cluster right here. I'll leave that big one. So again, you see the gills or the forked gills underside. And they're obviously in clusters. And you don't see the stem within. They all connect to the one single point in the backside. No stem. These are oyster mushrooms. Coyote den area again. Shit, if it came down to it, and a coyote bit me, my wild ass will bite that shit right back. Assert my dominance. Nah, they're sleeping right now. They're nocturnal, so they wake up in the nighttime, so I should be good. Falling down tree. All right, so these are also oysters. These are called mocked oysters. I never found these before. I have an app. Well, you take a picture of the mushroom and it tells you what it is. And I know the app is correct because it says that the mocked oysters has a smell like almost like a rotten egg smell. And sure enough, I smell these and they have a rotten egg smell to it. So I know these are mocked oysters. They're not poisonous, but people still stay away from them because of the smell. Some people do eat them. Some people just stay away from them because of the smell. Here are reishi mushrooms. These are really old, but they are one of my favorite mushrooms. This is a medicinal mushroom. This mushroom's a hard polymorph mushroom. It's too hard to eat, but you can break pieces off and make tea. And this is the first mushroom that really got me into fucking with mushrooms. Like, you could buy this as a powdered herb and you can take it as tea. And it literally opens up lung meridian, heart meridian, makes you feel super calm. It's a food, but it's a medicinal food. This is like real medicine right here that people really don't know about. I found one of these the other day for the first time. It was like, I was mad happy because this mushroom's like talked about in many different cultures, like ranked number one. They call it the queen of immortality, the queen of mushrooms. It's really known in, you know, like five different countries to be number one in medicinal properties. Look up reishi mushroom.
Yeah. Think about Mario Brothers. When you eat mushrooms, you grow bigger and stronger. The Japanese, that's not a coincidence. You know, mushrooms are powerful for healing, and we got to get back to eating natural medicine, not fucking chemical bullshit. Chemical bullshit, sniffing lines of sugar every morning for breakfast. That's not good. But fuck with this. You can buy this in a powdered form, put it in your coffee. You can make tea out of it, put it straight under the tongue. And it really does make you feel calm. Like, when you first try it, it's like life-changing. It's like, it's not a drug either, guys. It's a medicinal food. Boosting your immune system. This is like, mushrooms are known for boosting the immunity. Remodulating your whole immune system. Of course, we all want to... We all need mushrooms in our lives with all this bullshit COVID going on, or just to stay healthy in general. And I see more oyster mushrooms straight ahead, oh shit.
Like, if you don't stand for something, you'll die for nothing. There is no in between. You're either contributing to the rise or you're supporting the fall. The choice is yours. And what's crazy is, so is the outcome.